यस मैम।
ओके नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस दैट फर्स्ट लेसन न्यूट्रिशन फूड सप्लाइंग सिस्टम। So first lesson biological science food supply system. So all of you mention that in your rough notebook also lesson name and nutrition food supply system. So first of all nutrition means what? Nutrition means nothing but whatever you have to get in idea food. Yes or no?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, nutrition.
Yes ma'am.
You have to get an idea of food. So food is important. In this lesson, how to go learning about the nutrition and food, how to food supplying system supplying in the plants and the animals. So first of all, our primary needs. What are that? Our primary needs in previous class we have to learn that. What are our primary needs? Air, water. And food, then shelter. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Air, water, food, and shelter. These are our basic needs. So without air, we cannot live. And with 1 minute also, 1 second also, without air, we cannot live. We can't live. And without water also, we are not living. And without food, we are living. But 1 week or 1 month after then, we are not live. Possible to live that without food. Yes or no? So in that food yes, is mainly important our body growth. In that primary classes also you have to learn that the food is important our body development. Inside the functions will be done properly. So inside metabolism all functions done properly means that is the reason food only. Metabolism means what are that metabolism? Metabolism means respiration, digestion, circulation, excretion, reproduction. So these all are different metabolisms inside our body done. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, these are metabolisms done properly. That is the main food only. So the food is important. Why? Because that's why the food is we need food body development, growth, and our maintaining the temperature also. So in that. Single cellular organisms to multicellular organisms. Single cellular organisms to multicellular organisms take the food. We need to food. Yes or no? In previous class, you have to learn that single cellular organisms means what are the what is the meaning of single cellular organisms?
Organisms which contain single cell.
Okay, very good. So which the body will be made up of only one cell. So that are single cellular organisms. Example bacteria. Main examples bacteria and amoeba. Okay, amoeba. And multicellular organisms means so body will be made up of more cells. So that are multicellular organisms. Example, higher plants and higher all animals, multicellular organism. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you listen properly? After completion after class, I will ask the questions. Yeah. So that's why how to listen my class carefully. Okay, na?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, how to find out single cellular organism? Example, amoeba, multicellular organisms, higher. Plants and animals. And in the textbook, underline that whatever you have to easy do that whatever to do that one. Okay, these are that later also coming later coming to that point. Single cellular organisms to multicellular organism. Each and every organism need food. So, but different some organisms are taking different types of foods. For example. Some small animals, animals are eating some worms. Big animals are eating small animals. For example, human beings are eating both plants and animals. So, like the different organisms are eating different types of food. Okay, na? So, in the previous class, we had to learn that according to food habits, how many types of food habits animals are dividing three types: herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Herbivores means nothing but that organisms are taking only plant parts, that are herbivores. And example: cow, goat, elephant, rabbit. So these all are herbivores. And carnivores, so some animals, some organisms are eating only flesh only. Flesh means nothing but meat. So that are carnivores. Some organisms are eating both. One means plants and animals. Best example, human beings. So they are eating both food, plant parts and animals. Okay. Next here, what are in your textbook? See that what are autotrophs? What are heterotrophs? What are autotrophs and how to get their food? In your textbook, their question. And what are heterotrophs? Heterotrophs, how to get their food? So now let us discuss okay. What are autotrophs and what are heterotrophs? Autotrophs means some organisms are preparing own food. They are non-depending other organisms. They are preparing own by self only. So that are autotrophs. Best example, plants. Yes or no? The plants are preparing own food by the process of photosynthesis. They are not depending other animal, other organisms. So these are autotrophs. Autotrophs means keep in your mind which organisms are preparing, making own food.
Own food.
That are autotrophs.
Why just only?
Plants only. Plants. Heterotrophs. Which organisms are depending on other animals? Which organisms are depending on other animals for food purpose? So that are heterotrophs. Best example are animals. Yes or no? Animals are preparing own food?
No.
They are depending on plants and other animals. But plants,
other organisms.
Plants are depending food purpose other animals? No, the plants are preparing own.
No,
they are not depending other animals. So they are preparing own food by the process of photosynthesis. So which plants are?
Indra.
Which organisms are preparing own food? So.
Edvathano.
Autotrophs. Which organisms are depending on other animals food purpose? That are heterotrophs. Example, autotrophs, plants, and example, autotrophs and heterotrophs, animals. These are important. Autotrophs and heterotrophs in that exam purpose. Okay, now, next we have to go in that autotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition means nothing but the plants are preparing food by the photosynthesis process. So this is autotrophic nutrition. So in that the plants mainly sunlight energy, in that autotrophic nutrition, the sunlight energy will be changing into chemical energy. Sunlight energy changing into chemical energy. The sunlight autotrophic nutrition, the sunlight energy is changing into chemical energy. So this is autotrophic nutrition. So in this, plants using sunlight energy then changing into chemical energy. Chemical energy means carbohydrates. Nothing but chemical energy means carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are starch, glucose. These all are same meaning. Okay, now
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Give the reply. When I'm asking the questions, give two answers. So that time only I am understanding. Are you listen or not listen? Okay, na children.
Okay, madam.
Okay.
Okay.
Sunlight energy will be changing into chemical energy. So this is the autotrophic nutrition. So in that sunlight energy, the plants are using sunlight energy changing into chemical energy. Chemical energy means here food. Nothing but carbohydrates. Are you understand? So in that the plants are producing four factors by the photosynthesis process. So in that the sunlight energy changing into chemical energy, this process will be done by in that four factors are important. So salt, water, and minerals. So in that the four factors are important. This energy will be changing into chemical energy. So in that plants are using the water and minerals from this taking from the soil, carbon dioxide absorbing from the air, and using sunlight. The leaves will be present chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll substances will be present. So that's why that leaves are green in color. So this all factors are important for the photosynthesis process. So like that, the plants are using these factors and providing the energy. And providing energy means nothing but carbohydrates. So we are depending most of the animals, all animals directly, indirectly, we have to depending on the food purpose plants only. So that's why the plants are called universal providers. Are you understand?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Why? Because the plants is called universal providers.
Because they can give the
animals
food.
Are all animals directly, indirectly depend on plants only. We are eating animals, but most of the we are eating plant parts only. Okay, yes or no? So all animals are directly,
yes,
directly depending on plants only. So that's why plants are called universal providers. So in that, scientists have scientists is working so many years. They have to plants are how to perform the photosynthesis process. How to carry the life process means nothing but in that plants also done photosynthesis process, transpiration process, so reciprocation process. So like that, the scientists are worked about the plants life process. And the mainly the photosynthesis plants only main role in that plants are providing the food. So first the Von Helmont will be the scientist was Von Helmont. Scientist name, tell me. Von Helmont. Okay, the scientist was Von Helmont. So he told that the photosynthesis process, the plants are using only not only water, they are using other factors also. So the scientist was told other factors means. So in that previous, the scientists, they don't know photosynthesis, what is the photosynthesis, what factors are need for photosynthesis. They don't know. They have to did lot of work and they work for so many years. Then we have to give an information, the photosynthesis, these factors are important than the photosynthesis process. Okay, now children?
Okay.
So the one thing, okay, the scientist was, first you we observed the plants are not only need water for photosynthesis process, so other factors also important than the photosynthesis process. Okay, next the photosynthesis. So in that we have to explain that photosynthesis process, what is the meaning of photosynthesis? Okay, note that these all are not the children. As textbooks there means you have to keep the underline. Okay. Okay, children.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Photosynthesis. So in that photosynthesis means organic molecules changing into inorganic molecules. So organic compounds are organic compounds changing into inorganic. Means here organic compounds, what are the carbon dioxide, water and mineral, chlorophyll, so sunlight, these all are factors of interacted each and one. So then finally chemical compounds are nothing but inorganic substances, are nothing but glucose. These all are same meaning. Okay na children?
Okay ma'am.
Okay ma'am.
So these are all are organic, means photosynthesis means nothing but first organic substances will into inorganic substances. So organic substances means the plants are absorbing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, water and minerals absorbing the roots are absorbing water and minerals from the soil. Next, due to the sunlight, chlorophyll, these four are interacted each and every one, then finally compound carbo food will be formed. Okay na children? So this is the photosynthesis.
Okay,
so in the so many 200 years ago, over the 200 years, the so many scientists are try to get given the photosynthesis formula, but they are not successful. First in that 1931, Henry Van Leeuwen in the photosynthesis formula. So according to his opinion, in that in your textbook have me see the textbook that reaction carbon dioxide and water molecule gives us to, this is not aerobic, gives us to CH2O means carbohydrate and water, you know, oxygen will be released. So his given formula CP1 in that 1931, he proposed the photosynthesis formula. And like chlorophyll, note down this formula. In the textbook also there.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, and you have to no need to note down also. You have to maintain the textbook, means keep the underline. Okay, na? That is the main points.
Ma'am.
Okay, in that according to his opinion, in the photosynthesis process, one carbohydrate molecule releases one water molecule. And one oxygen molecule will be released. Are you understand?
Explain once again. Please explain once again.
Okay, again once again. Okay, okay. CP1
yes, ma'am. 1931
is given formula. One formula according photosynthesis formula. So in that photosynthesis, the main four factors are important. What are the carbon dioxide, water molecule, sunlight, and chlorophyll? Okay, chlorophyll. These four molecules will be reacted each and one. These all are organic compounds. Then carbohydrate molecule, water molecule, and carbohydrate molecule. These are inorganic compounds or chemical compounds. Good. Are you understand? So according to his opinion. So in the carbon dioxide, carbon dioxide and water, their light, chlorophyll reacted each and one, everyone, and the inter reacted then carbohydrate. One molecule of carbohydrate released and one molecule of water molecule, one molecule of oxygen will be released. In your textbook, liberated in which, liberated is there. Liberated means released. Okay, na?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, liberated, then dagger are released and write down. Okay?
Okay, so, ma'am. Okay,
are you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one, the CB1 ne again now to study about the this photosynthesis process. Yes. In the is observed in the sulfur bacteria. Sulfur bacteria. In the textbook, there means you have to see that next paragraph. Okay, sulfur bacteria. So he has studied that about photosynthesis process in that sulfur bacteria. So he told that the photosynthesis process, the main role in that light is the main role. He told light was plays main role in the photosynthesis process. He is observed in the sulfur bacteria. Okay, in that sulfur bacteria, in the photosynthesis process, water molecule, water, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll, sunlight. Another factor is water. That water. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, are you able to listen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but here the sulfur bacteria in that observing. So here, ma'am, this bacteria is not using water. So in that water, hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfur. Okay. Okay, children.
Okay, ma'am.
Madam. Okay, ma'am.
So in that sulfur bacteria, he observed sulfur bacteria. So he told it plays main role in that photosynthesis process. So here using that not water plays. So it is this bacteria will be using hydrogen sulfur, and then they are to preparing or these factors all are interacted, and you put carbohydrates are preparing, but here sulfur will be releasing. Are you understand? Sulfur will be
released.
Next to that, Robert Hill, the scientist, another scientist, what are the
Robert Hill.
Robert, first scientist, what scientist? In that before, two scientist names are I announced. What are the scientists?
Von.
Okay, CB Von name. Next one?
Robert Hill.
Von Helmont. Okay. Von Helmont.
Von Helmont.
Okay, next.
Robert Hill.
Robert Hill also observing so many plants. According by the photosynthesis process, he observed more plants. And he told, he given the information, the plants are not using sulfur. I told in that sulfur, bacteria will be using sulfur in that water place. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
And they are releasing sulfur in that oxygen place.
Sulfur.
Okay. But Robert Hill will be told, they have to did this lot of hard work and struggle. And observing more plants, and they given the information. So in that, so many plants are using carbon dioxide. Here they write that information. 6CO2 plus 12H2O gives us to lime, chlorophyll, and 6H2O6. This is carbohydrate. 6H2O means water and oxygen. 6O2. So write down. This is not this equation. So in that, if you want to give in one equation, yes or no? Okay, now CB1 is given one equation, carbon dioxide plus 2H water molecule, then carbon, already I wrote that. Again, I write that. This is CB1 equation, carbon dioxide, 2H2O, light, chlorophyll, CH2, carbohydrate,
water,
water molecule, and oxygen.
And oxygen.
Okay. Okay, children, are you listen?
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, CB1 name is.
Yes, ma'am.
Equation. So this is first equation, photosynthesis formula. Yes or no?
Yes.
But
yes,
now
ma'am.
This equation will be modified. Who modified? The scientist was Robert Hill.
Robert Hill
modified this equation. Now we have to following not this equation. This equation only we are following. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
This equation not this one. CB1 name is given that, but we are not following. This equation only we are following. Okay. What that equation? 6CO2 plus 2H2O gives us
plus 2H2O.
Chlorophyll. Then C6H12O6. This is carbohydrates or starch, glucose. Then water molecule 6H2O and 6O2 oxygen. Are you understand? Then we have to follow this equation. Okay, now children.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Add four factors in photosynthesis process. Four factors are tell me the photosynthesis process done means which factors are important? Here
water.
Only there. Only there. Carbon dioxide.
Water.
CO2.
Sunlight, chlorophyll.
CO2 means nothing but carbon dioxide. Water. H2O means water molecule. This is like sunlight and chlorophyll. These all are light energy or organic substances. Then react with each and everyone, changing into carbohydrate. Okay, now children. Means?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, madam.
CC H2O6, and then finally water will be released. Oxygen will be released to atmosphere. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, children.
Okay, ma'am.
Are you understand photosynthesis?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. These are four factors. Important. The photosynthesis process done means the factors are carbon dioxide, water molecule, sunlight, chlorophyll. Why? Because the 3-4 times I repeat means this is important. Okay, now children.
Okay, ma'am.
Like the plants are preparing. If this all photosynthesis process, in that which part will be done? Leaves. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Chlorophyll
means
nothing but leaves. Are you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the plants are like that preparing food, and that food will be stored in that root parts, leaves parts, stem parts, or starch, carbohydrates like that proteins, lipids. Are you understand? Okay, children. We are eating some plant root parts, some plant leaves parts. That is food. The plants are preparing. They have to store it in different plant parts. Yes or no? Some food we are eating nuts. That are stored in that, the food will be nuts. Some plants will be preparing food, that food will be stored in the stems. We are eating stem parts, for example, sugar cane. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
We are eating root parts, carrot. The plants are preparing food, they have to store it in the roots. Our carbohydrate, our starch, glucose, nothing but proteins, lipids, whatever they are preparing food. That are stored in a different plant parts that we are eating. Okay, children?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, here the questions is there. So in that life that the plants are capable to preparing own food, but animals are not capable to preparing the own food. Yes or no? We are depending on other plants or organisms. That's why we which type of nutrition nutrition in that animals?
Heterotrophic nutrition.
Preparing own food means that which type of nutrition?
Autotrophic nutrition.
Example, autotrophic nutrition.
Plants.
Heterotrophic nutrition.
Animals and humans.
Very good. Next, in that, all of you have textbook, I don't know, but next activity. 21 is there in our textbook. Okay, children?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, now let us
discuss. I did not have textbook.
All of you note down as keep textbooks some members things have means you have to underline them. Okay now? Okay, in that activity one, presence of stops in leaves. So in that in activity presence of stops in leaves, so this is experiment. So in that already we told in that photosynthesis process plants are preparing food. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Which
place? Yes, ma'am.
The food will be preparing. The photosynthesis process done which place? Leaves.
Leaves.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Leaves. That leaves have starch. Means starch means nothing but carbohydrate, starch, glucose. Same meaning. So in that leaves, the photosynthesis process preparing the food are starch. So now we have to prove that experimentally. Okay, na?
Okay, ma'am.
You know that experiment aim. Experiment. What are that important aim? Material requires. Yes or no? In the previous 9th class also did some experiment.
Yes. And yes, ma'am.
Material required. Aim. So finally. What are the aim? Our aim is presence of starch in leaves. Now we have to prove that experimentally. Okay, na children?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am.
Aim is presence of starch in leaves. Material required. Beaker. Boiling water. In the textbook, there means no need to write down. Just to see that and you have to keep the underline. Burner. Bird sun. Mitten spirit. Okay, children. Our aim is presence of starch in leaves. So in that experiment, what have to we have to prove that?
To find the starch in leaves.
Very good. Give the answers means and I understand that you are able to listen or not able to. Please try to give the answers. Okay, na children. You have to any
okay,
doubt
ma'am.
After completion
okay,
of class,
ma'am.
Ask the question. Okay, this experiment
okay,
after
ma'am.
I will stop the class and ask the question. Okay, children.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, listen carefully. So presence of starch in leaves. Now we have to prove that. So material required. So in that diagram is there. So now, all of you books have means, notebooks have means, draw the diagram. Okay, na? Roughly. Okay, children?
Okay, ma'am.
So, we have to diagram. Drawing means, we have to easily understand the total matter. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So, that's why you have to draw the diagram. I am also draw the rough diagram.